As promised, this is another video highlighting the agreements between the Seventh-day Adventist General Conference and the Roman Catholic Vatican. And what I'm about to share now is something most in the SDA Church would never believe unless you actually showed them proof in writing. And so here's hoping some are actually going to start believing what's going on here. As we know, the Roman Catholic Church has what they call cloistered nuns in their hierarchical structure. And you might want to check this page out online when you get a chance that defines just what that means. In fact, this is actually one of the six signs of a cult that I shared many years ago in this video. And so notice what the Roman Catholic Church says about their nuns here. They said, by force of their vocation, which sets them at the heart of the church, nuns undertake in a special way to have the mind of the church, with sincere adherence to the magisterium and unreserved obedience to the Pope. Well, that all being said, is there any documentation in the Seventh-day Adventist Church wherein they actually admit there are nuns, or worse yet, cloistered nuns who are subordinate to their superiors and show unreserved obedience to the president in the same way Catholic nuns are to the Pope and the prelates? Well, notice what the Seventh-day Adventist General Conference said in this statement. Those who work for the Seventh-day Adventist Church respond to a religious vocation in exactly the same sense as does a cloistered nun. No, they don't wear the black habit of the nun, as far as I know. But as we see here, the Seventh-day Adventist General Conference describes these women that work for the church as having the same sincere adherence to the magisterium, or leaders in the SDA Church, as well as the president, as does a Roman Catholic nun who will, with unreserved obedience, do as the president of the Seventh-day Adventist Church commands them to do, in the same way a nun obeys the Pope of Rome, who will dictate Vatican dogma and church tradition as per his own opinion. Hence the reason I illustrated in my previous video as to why the Seventh-day Adventist Church needs the same pagan hierarchical structure as the Vatican does. It wouldn't work without it. This admission of the General Conference in a court transcript, no less, proves they uplift the president of the Seventh-day Adventist Church above Jesus Christ in the exact same way the Pope is lifted up by his subordinates to be another God on earth. Thank you for watching. God bless.